these things for us. We welcome you as guests to our church, and we pray that in some way we can help you, you'll let us know. That tonight will be special meaning to your life. Mine means a lot to each of my Baptist church. May we have a word of prayer together, please. Father, we thank you so much for your love. We thank you for giving us the time that we can join together in one place. We can lift up you in praise, and we can say thank you for all that you've done for us. Be with each and every person that's here, and we pray that tonight will be an uplifting time. They can say thank you, Jesus, for allowing me to come, and they'll feel good about life when they leave. For it's in your name we pray. Amen. Let's give Mike a big hand. Mike, you come.
Would surely be me. preacher on the front steps shaking everybody's hand. A sign shaped like a Bible, saying summer revival. But there's a million dead churches just filling up an acre of land. What we need is a soul, a filling station, full service open 24 hours a day. Open the line of change, super salvation.
Thank you. time, that's all. Just so the saints can tell that their journey's almost over. But for some, it's just beginning. And it's a journey into fear and dread for all of those who, well, they're just not ready for being yet. But I'm here to tell you there's still hope in sight. And if you're long lost and afraid, well, you still got time to make things right. Because you see, I know the way out of this mess that we're in. And in case you've forgotten, I want to take just another minute to tell you his name.
See us through the end.
It was such an ordeal he had to go through, you know, just to pray. And I'm so glad that now we, just common people like us, we can go before the throne of God with our petitions, with our prayers, and with our needs. And we can just go, just us. I mean, it don't have to be anybody else. Just me, I can go, you can go. Listen to this song. It's a beautiful song. It says, now I can go into the Holy of Holies.
Set the arm.
might sing a few courses together on the back side of the sheet. You'll find three courses together. But we're going to...
To him, for Jesus is the right.
right music goes in the right spot. I appreciate you, Kevin.
I'm
Have you ever felt like in your Christian walk that that you stumbled and you felt like you're just on the bottom? And I see some of you smiling. I think you've been there. I've been there. You feel like you're on the bottom and you just can't get up. I didn't mean to say I fall and I can't get up. But you know, sometimes you do get down. You know, you have to tell somebody, I am down and I can't get up and I need help. I can tell you where the help is tonight. And the first step of the help is for us people to recognize those needs around us. And when we see somebody that's down, go to them. If they don't come to us first, and show them how to get up. Pray with them. This next song, I want you to listen close to the words, because it may be speaking about one of you and about me. I want you to just listen to the words, and you'll get the message. I'm higher than I've ever been. Let me tell you what I know. That's not some reason there's more heat outside than there is cold air blowing in here, so the heat outside is overpowering the cold air, so we're not going to be much longer. But I want to sing one more song, and I want to close out with this, and I want you to think about it. And, you know, I told you we're here to have a good time tonight, but we want to be serious, too. We want you to really think about this. I've been singing about somebody that is a part of my life and has changed my life and has made my life better than it could ever be any other way. There's nobody else that could do for my life what he has done, and that's Jesus. And I know, without a doubt, that if he came right now, that I would go with him. But I'm not sure that each one of you know that, because I don't know each one of you. But I want you to think about that tonight. You know, we as Christians need to be telling people. We need to be telling our friends, our families, people that we don't even know, that Jesus is coming soon. And we want to go with him when he comes. And if we're not ready, if we don't have him in our hearts and our lives, then we're going to miss him. And I don't want you to leave tonight being unsure about that. I want you to really know, just like I know, that if he came right now, I could go with him. And I would go with him. And I want you to listen to a song that my wife wrote. And in fact, it's the title of an album I have. It says, "You Better Get Ready." And that's really true tonight. If you're not ready to meet him, I want you to get ready. And you can get ready in your heart. You can get ready right where you're sitting. You can get ready down here at this altar. Or you can get somebody to pray with you. And I'm not asking you to do anything tonight that you don't want to do. I just want you to think about it. And I want you to, as you leave tonight, I want you to know for sure which direction you're going. And I want you to know that you're going the same direction that I'm going. And that's straight up when he comes. And you think about it as I sing this last song. You better be ready.
Hey.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for this time that you've given us. We thank you, Lord, for one more opportunity to serve you in the way that you've given us to serve. I thank you, Lord, for every person that's here tonight. I feel honored that they came out tonight, but I know that you feel more honored than I do. And I just thank you for their presence. And I pray tonight, Lord, that something has been said or something has been sung that they needed to hear. You know, Lord, when I sing, even though it's something that I've sung before, it speaks to me all over again. And I know that you allow that to happen, and I thank you for it. And I just pray that what I have sung tonight, and maybe it's something that several people here have heard many times, but it was brand new again. It just turned on a little light or something, or it says something that they needed to hear tonight. I pray that you will bless every person here. I pray that you will go with us as we leave. And I pray that you will give each one of us more opportunities to be in your house and to worship you. And Lord, if there's a heart here tonight that is not ready to meet you, I pray that they'll come to me or even someone else here before they leave tonight and say, what can I do to make sure that I'm going in the direction that you're going? Because I want to go with you. I want to go with him when he comes back. Lord, if they don't have the strength to come to one of us and ask us, give them the strength to pray to you. And say, Lord, I know I need you, and I want you to come into my heart tonight. I don't want to lay down and sleep another night without you. Lord, we thank you for your presence. We thank you for everything. Most of all, we thank you for Jesus, for him dying for us, for the salvation that he's made available to each one of us. And I thank you for that everlasting peace that's in my heart, in the hearts of every Christian. When this world tries to get us down, when people try to do things to us, when we misunderstand people, when they misunderstand us, we can throw all that aside and put it behind us and still know that peace that you gave us from the beginning is still there. And we don't have to worry about those things. That's the beauty, Lord, of knowing you, is to know that even when things get tough, we still have that wonderful peace inside. We are so thankful for that tonight. Thank you again, Lord, for this time. I just